Season 2 of Mary Kills People is pretty intense.
What would I do in this situation?
The stakes are a lot higher.
It's a lot more twisty-turny this year.
Everyone's a little bit crazier and a bit more amped up this season.
It's dark and it's brooding.
It's dangerous. It's morbid.
Unpredictable.
So many shocking things that happen.
Smart. Sexy.
Sarah Armstrong is definitely a genius.
It's just so well written.
My name is Mary. I will kill you too.
In season 2, I think fans can expect more plot twists, lots of surprises.
Yeah, it's 8 months later and Mary has her act together. She's having a great time. She's going to Mexico and killing people happily, all solo. Poor Dez is off in prison growing a big beard. When we come back into our world, Dez is about to get out of prison on early parole. Mary's returning from Mexico and then he wants back into the business.
The stakes are definitely higher, so the danger is even more palpable. The relationship between Dez and Mary becomes more complicated than it was in season 1. She becomes a little more dangerous. I think she's darker in season 2.
Mary and Dez are somewhat shifting track. Mary, she has rather questionable motives. And Dez is a far stronger man than he was last year.
Dez joining the business, it's actually an escape from his addiction. And so becoming a part of the business, for the most part, actually is this really positive thing in his life.
The fact that he's ultimately a very good man and doing this for the right reasons is abundantly clear this year, which is very interesting and very bold to make the ex-heroin addict, man of wrong choices, the moral compass.
Ben's been back on the undercover kind of circus. He's been working a job in Detroit, which has affected him in a way. You know, he comes back a little tired and deflated. So he's looking for, I guess he's looking for more of a family. He doesn't want to be that lone wolf anymore, I guess.
From a creative perspective of approaching season 2, something I think is great when watching TV is like when you're able to sort of put yourselves in the shoes of character.
We started Mary kind of in an ordinary world in season 1 and kind of took her to a dark place. And so season 2 is a bit of a reckoning for some of the decisions she made in season 1.
Grady dying did not solve any of her problems. It probably made them worse. And now she's stuck with a new bad guy who turns out to be a bad girl.
If you thought the villain of season 1 was scary, this villain of season 2 may be scarier.
Olivia is the force that comes to set Mary's life even more off balance than it was before. I think season 2 asks a really interesting question, which is how much of this is happening to Mary and she's a victim because she's just trying to do what she thinks is the right thing? And how much of it is because she's inviting these forces into her life?
Inevitably, when you're breaking a first season, you're like, oh, well, this should happen in second season. You start to generate these ideas for second season.
We really just wanted to stay true to what made season 1 a success, watching Mary go through the world and really being driven by her compassion to help people die, but also what she's doing is illegal and it causes her to fall into this criminal life.
Gray zones that we were flirting with in season 1 were definitely really into this season.
And these scripts come in and you're like, oh my God, of course. This is of course where it's gonna go. But it feels inevitable and shocking.
The stakes get higher and things get more complicated as we go forward.